Hi friends, today we are going to discuss about the evaluation matrix part 3, confusion matrix for the multi-class classification. So in previous lecture I already discussed about the binary class classification. So what is the difference between binary class classification and multi-class classification? So here, binary class means in the target variable only two classes are existed, means 0 or 1, yes or no, true or false, like that. So this kind of values are existed in the target variable, we used to call the binary class. If we have more than two classes, nothing but the multi-class. So multi-class means, for example, cat, dog and rat. So three different kind of classes. So in this example we are considering the three classes, class A and class B and class C, three classes we are considering. So the following possible confusion matrix of the three classes. Okay, here this is the 3 by 3 matrix. So in the 3 by 3 matrix, here I am considering the on y-axis actual values, or other name true values or real values. So on real values, we are considering the class A, class B and class C. So here on x-axis I am considering the predicted values. So what is the actual values and what is the predicted values means? Suppose here I am considering the simple data set. So in simple data set I am considering only two rows, x1, x2, y. So the data set shape is 10 by 3, means 10 rows, means 10 instances, means 10 rows or instances. Rows or instances are 3 columns. So these two columns is the input features, and this y is nothing but the, this is the target variable or the actual value or the real value or the true value. So here instance 1, instance 2 up to instance 10. Okay, so here the input data is not a matter. The input data may be either categorical data or numerical data, not a matter. So here our main intention is the target variable. So target variable y has the values, here consider the three classes, class A, class B, class C. So here this is the class A. So instance 1 means first row is class A, second row is class B, and third row is class C, and A, B, C, like that. So here total number of class A and total number of class B, total number of class C out of 10 instances. So out of 10 instances, the total number of class A, so this is total number of class A of the actual values, 4 instances. So what are the 4 instances? 2 plus 2 plus 0 is nothing but the 4 instances. And total number of instances is the 4 instances. See, total under class B and actual values, 2 plus 1 plus 1, 4 instances. And total number of instances under class C is the 2 instances. Total 10 instances of the data set. So this is the y. So here what is the y hat, means this is the predicted. This is nothing but the predicted. So predicted means here predicted by the model. So here maybe actually here A, it may be predicted as either A or B or C, depends upon the model. Okay. So this predicted values y hat is nothing but the class A, class B, class C. So this x axis is nothing but the y hat, means predicted values. So here original class A and model predicted as A. So these matching rows are 2. So total number of 2 out of 4 classes, 2 classes are correctly predicted and 2 classes are the wrongly predicted. So after 4 instances, 1 class is correctly predicted, 2 instances wrongly predicted, and 1 instance wrongly predicted. So means 2 plus 1, 3. three instances wrongly predicted. So after two instances are correctly predicted. So these two instances are wrongly predicted. So in my previous lecture, I already explained the evaluation matrix of classification algorithms is the accuracy, precision, recall, and F1 score. So, among these four evaluation metrics, three metrics are repeated in this micro average matrix and macro average matrix and the weighted average matrix. If you see, micro average precision, micro average recall, and micro average F1 score. Similarly, macro under the macro matrix, macro precision, macro recall, macro F1 score. So similarly, weighted average based precision, weighted average recall, and weighted F1 score. So among these three metrics, the precision means TP by TP plus FP is repeated, and recall TP by TP plus FN is also be repeated, and F1 score. So F1 score means 2 into precision into recall by precision plus recall. So these three formulas are repeated in micro, macro, and weighted. So if you see the what is the micro average matrix. So micro, under the micro averaging, we have to calculate the performance of the model. So how can you calculate the performance of the model? For example, you have to see the precision from this individual classes, individual predictions, true predict TP and FP from the K classes. So here, precision of micro. So this is the under micro. So what is the meaning of TP1 to TPK? So here TP1 means total K is equal to 3. So means TP1 plus TP2 plus TP3 by TP1 plus TP2 plus TP3 plus FP1 plus FP2 plus FP3. So here why we are taking 1, 2, 3? So actually 3 classes. That's why we are taking the class 1, class 2, class 3. So instead of like that, you can write like that TPA, TPB plus TPC. Same thing you have to write here. And plus instead of the FP1, FPA, FPB, and FPC. Why? Because so this is the formula related to precision. Precision means TP. So this is under total TP. The same thing will be here, TP plus the FPA, FP, FPC, nothing but the FP. So like that. So in multi-class classification, so micro average is preferable. So when it is preferable? When the class is imbalanced. The class is imbalance. So what is mean by imbalance? Suppose this is our data set. So in the data set, this is the x1, x2, y. So in this y, they are the instances. For example, class A, class B, class C. So here class A, out of 10 instances, class A is the, for example, I'm considering the 5 instances, class B is 3 instances, class C is 2 instances, for example. So these three different classes is the different range. In nothing but this is imbalance. So if it is balance means, suppose instead of A, I were taking the 3, class B is 3, class C is 3, out of 9 instances. So out of 9 instances, so 3, 3, 3, this is the balanced data. Out of 10 instances, if you see 5, 3, 2, this is imbalanced data. So when the data is imbalanced, at that moment we are considering this kind of matrix, that is the micro, like that. So here macro. So macro means it is the average of the precision and recall. So it's macro average precision. So macro average precision means precision 1 means precision A plus precision B plus precision C divided by number of classes 3. N means number of classes 3. Similarly, recall A plus recall B plus recall C divided by N. Okay, so if you see the practical section, how we are going to implement this micro, macro, precision, and F1 score, all these things. So this is the simple coding part. So here configure matrix for the multi-class classification. First I am importing the required libraries, that is the pandas and numpy. So import the pandas as pd and import the numpy as np. Next, in the second cell I am considering the actual values. Actual values means the our target variables. Here I am considering the three classes, class A and class B and class C, three different categories I am considering for understanding purpose. So here this is the index values from 0 to 9, means total 10 instances. And this is the cell 3, this is the predicted values. So this is the actual values and this is the predicted values. So now we are constructing the confusion matrix. So if the confusion matrix is applied on this actual and predicted, you got the confusion matrix of the 3x3. So 3x3 confusion matrix you will get. So for getting the confusion matrix, we need the confusion matrix library from the scikit-learn dot matrix. So this is the 3x3 confusion matrix. So in the 3x3 confusion matrix, this is the class A and this is the class B and this is the class C. If you see the classification report, this is the class A. Under class C we have to calculate the precision, recall and F1 score. So under out of 10 instances, class A has the 4 instances and class B has the 4 instances and class C has the 2 instances. So if you use this library classification report on the actual values and predicted values, you will get this report. In this report we will see how mathematically we will get this values. This all values we can see mathematically, how each and every value we supposed to get by mathematically. Okay, so first we have to see this precision, we have to see the confusion matrix of the class A. So here I am constructing the one confusion matrix. So this is the one confusion matrix. So this confusion matrix is the 3x3. What is the values we got? This is the values we got from the confusion matrix. The values are the 220, 220, 211, 211, and 002, 002. So this is the class A, class B, class C, and this is the actual values and this is the predicted values, and the predicted values class A, class B, class C. Okay, so we have to calculate the precision of class A, and we have to calculate the recall of class A and F1 score of class A. So what is the generally precision formula? Tp by Tp plus Fp. And for recall formula, Tp by Tp plus Fn. And F1 score is the 2 into precision into recall divided by precision plus recall. So this is for the binary class. If it is multi class means it is very difficult. What is the FP? So that's why you are calculate the true positive. So here true positive means for class A, true positive of the class A. So here what I am doing, so this is the, I am considering for the understanding purpose, considering this is the C1, means cell 1, cell 2, cell 3, cell 4, cell 5, cell 6, 7, 8, 9. So true positive A, TPA means this is the TP means cell 1. So TP means C1 is nothing but the value 2. So what is the FPA? False positive under A. So false positive means this is the false positive means cell 4 plus cell 7. So cell 4 value is 2, cell 7 value is 0. So nothing but the 2. And what is the false negative under class A? False negative means this is the false negative under class A. So cell 2 plus cell 3, 2 plus 0, 2. And this remaining part we have to consider as a true negative class A. So true negative class A is equal to C5, C6, C8 plus C9. So C5 value 1 plus 1 plus 0 plus 2 4. So this is the formula. So now we can substitute these values. So this is the TPA. TPA value 2 plus FPA value 2 by 2. So you will get the 2 by 2 by 4 0.5. So 2 by 2 plus FNA. So FNA means FNA value 2 0.5. So you can substitute the value 2 into 0.5 into 0.5 by 0.5 plus 0.5 is equal to this value 0.5. See, precision of the class A 0.5, recall of the class A is 0.5, and F1 score of the class A is 0.5. So this is the with respect to the class A. Now we have to calculate the with respect to the class B. So with respect to the class B, values are the same, 2 2 0 and 2 1 2 1 1 and 0 0 2. So now this is the value on class A, class B, class C, class A, class B, class C. Similarly, we have to calculate the for class B, precision TPB by TPB plus FPB and recall of the class B, TPB plus TPB plus false negative B. So F1 score of class B, 2 into precision B into recall B plus precision B plus recall B. So what is the true positive for class B? So this is the true, this is the cell 1, cell 2, cell 3, cell 4, cell 5, cell 6, cell 7, cell 8 and cell 9. So TPB means cell 5 means value 1. And what is the false positive with respect to B class? So false positive means C2 plus 8 2 plus 0 2. So FB value 2. And what is the false negative with respect to class B? False negative means this is the false negative, this value and this value, means C4 plus C6, 2 plus 1, 3. And what is the true negative with respect to B? True negative means, so this is the C1, C3, C7 and C9. C9 means 2 plus 0 plus 0 plus 2 is nothing but 4. So we can substitute values here. What is the pressure of B? TPB means 1 by 1 plus FPB value 2. So this value is nothing but the 0.33. 1 by 1 plus FNB, FNB means 3, 1 by 4, 0.25. So you can substitute these values, 2 into pressure B, 0.33, 0.25 by 0.33 plus 0.25, you will get the value 0.29. So this is the precision with respect to class B. This is the precision recall B with respect to class B. This is the F1 score with respect to class B. So these all values are different. Now, the same confusion matrix 2, 2, 0, 2, 1, 1. 002. This is the class A, class B, class C, class A, class B, class C. So here, what is the formula? This is the for class C precision. Precision of class C is nothing but the true positive B TPC TPC plus FPC. And recall of C, TPC by TPC plus CFNC, and F1 score of class C, true into precision with respect to class C, recall with respect to class C by precision with respect to C plus recall with respect to C. So we have to calculate. So what is the true positive with respect to C? True positive with respect to C means this is the cell 1, cell 2, cell 3, cell 4, cell 5, cell 6, 7, 8, cell 9. So this is the cell 9 is nothing but the value 2. So false positive with respect to C. False positive means this value. Cell 3 plus cell 6, 0 plus 1, 1, 0 plus 1, 1. So false negative with respect to C. False negative with respect to means this is the false negative. Cell 7, cell 8, 0 plus 0, 0. False negative. True negative with respect to C. So this is the true negative. Cell 1, cell 2, cell 4, cell 5. 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 1, 7. So we can substitute these values. TPC 2 by 2 plus FPC value 1. 2 by 2 by 1, nothing but the 0.67. So 2 by 2 plus FNC, FNC value is 0, nothing but 1. So 2 into 0.67 by 1, 0.67 plus 1. 0.80. So we will see these values. See. So what are the values we got? The same thing we got. If you see, this is with respect to class C. With respect to class C, 0.67, 1, 0.80, 0.67. 0.67, 1 and 0.80, and for class C, number of instances class C. If you see, this is the class B. In class B, precision 0.33, 0.25, 0.29. You remember these values. For class B, precision of the 0.33. Recall of B 0.25, F1 score of B is 0.29, 0.33, 0.25, 0.29. 0.33. See, with respect to class B, 0.33, 0.25, 0.29. So number of instances with respect to B is 4. Similarly, if you see class A, so this is class A. Class A, all are same, 0.5. Whatever you got the values, all are same. Precision is 5.5, recall 0.5, FM score 0.5. If you see here, see all are getting the same value. For class A, 0.5, recall of the class A 0.5, FM score of the class A 0.5, and number of instances for it, for supporting for class A 4. So, till now we are in this part, we calculated mathematically. So every value we got by mathematically. Now we will look into these values. What is the accuracy? What is the macro? What is the weighted? So what is the accuracy? So accuracy formula 0.5. So accuracy means true positive A plus true positive B plus true positive C with respect to the all predictions. So what is the TPA value? So TPA 2. TPA means the diagonal elements 2, 1, 2 by 10. Means 5 by 10 means 0.5. So TPA value means the diagonal elements of the confusion matrix. If you see, yeah, this is the TPA, this one is the TPB, this value is the TPC. So 2 plus 2 plus 1, so by all predictions means all means 220 means 4, 2114, 00 to 10. So total 10 instances like that. So accuracy by mathematical 0.5, and by executing the code you will get the 0.5. So we'll look into this micro average matrix. So micro means, this is the formula. Micro average means true positive with respect to A, and true positive with respect to B, true positive with respect to C. So these all values we are calculated. So we can substitute these values. We substitute these values. So what is the true positive A? TPA, this value 2. TPB value is 1. TPC value, so means TP value 5. So FPA value 2, FPB 2, and FPC 1. So these values we got the from the confusion matrix of the class A, confusion matrix of the class B. If you see, if you are getting doubt, see, this is the TPA. So TPA means 2, FPA with respect to class A, FPA value is 2. So like that, from every confusion matrix we know the FPB and FNB, FNC. So you can substitute this value, so you got the same. So this value is 5. So if you substitute this value, this value is nothing but the 5, this value is nothing but the 5, this value 5. So that value is nothing but the totally 0.5. So if you execute this statement, so from sklearn.matrix precision score, so this is the library from the scikit-learn, so we are printing the micro average precision. So micro average here precision score, so applied on the actual values, y values, predicted values, y hat. So this is the metric, the average is equal to the micro. So here our micro precision means this is the micro with respect to the precision. So, what value we got, we can look into after executing this cell, we will see what is the value we will get. See, we get the same value, we will get the same value 0.5. Similarly, recall also be same. If you execute the this values TPA, TPB, TPC, we know all values, and FNE, FNB, FNC. If you substitute these values, you will get the recall value. If you execute this value 0.5, and F1 score 2 into this is the formula for the micro average F1 score 2 into micro precision into micro recall by micro precision plus micro recall. You can substitute these values mathematically, you will get the what is the value you got 0.5. The same thing you also get. If you see in this here 2.1 micro precision value is 0.5, in 2.2 means micro recall value is 0.5, and micro F1 score is also by the 0.5. So if you execute this classification report, see accuracy, what is the accuracy you got? 0.5. So what is the accuracy you got there? The same values also be see micro average precision 0.5, micro average score recall 0.5, micro average F1 score is also be the 0.5. So what does that mean? So here accuracy is equal to the micro, precision equal to the micro, recall equal to the micro, F1 score all are 0.5 0.5 0.5 0.5. That's why here micro is not visible, not available in this classification report. Why? Because here what is the accuracy you will get, the same is be same for the micro precision, micro recall, micro F1 score. So all are same. That is the reason. See here micro precision 0.5, here by mathematical micro precision 0.5, micro average 0.5, and micro F1 score 0.5. So all are same. That's why here accuracy is also be the 0.5. So micro average precision and micro average recall, micro average F1 score, which is equal to the accuracy. So next macro average matrix. So what is the macro average matrix? So under the macro average matrix, precision, recall, F1 score. So under 3.1 macro average precision. So macro precision is used for the models with more than two target classes. So more than two target class means multi class. So macro average performer first computing the precision of each class. So precision of each class means already in three classes we already calculated the. So what is the meaning of this precision of each class? And means precision of class A and precision of class B and precision of class C. So precision of each class we have calculated taking the average. Taking average means by 3. So that is the meaning of the macro average precision. So this is the TPA, TPA by TPA plus FPA means this is the precision A, this is the precision B, plus this is the precision C. So that's why I read the formula same here, precision A plus precision B plus precision C by N. So what is this values of precision A and B? So if you execute this cell, so 0.5 means you can substitute here precision of A. What is the precision of A? This is the precision of A 0.5, precision of B 0.33, and precision of class C is the 0.67. So three different categories. So if you club this thing, so here precision of class A is the 0.5 plus 0.33 and plus 0.67 by 3, you will get the answer 0.5. So this formula can be written as macro average precision. This formula first also you can write like this: sigma I is equal to 1 to n TPI by TPI plus FPI divided by n. So here I equal to 1 to n, n means number 3. So means TP1 by TP1 plus FP1 plus TP2 by TP2 plus FP2 plus TP3 by TP3 plus FP3 by n means 3 classes. So this is the formula, is the this formula both are same like that. So this is the major formula. From this formula we got we can write like this: TP1 by TP1 plus TP1 means A, 2 means B, C means 3, like that. So like what we got the procedure for the macro average precision, the same formula here, but here instead of the FP we are taking the FN. The procedure same. So 0.588, you can substitute this values here. So here TPA value, macro average, so this value is nothing but the 0.5, this value is nothing but the 0.05, this value is nothing but the 1. So 0.5 plus 0.25 plus 1 by 3, you will get the answer 0.583, which means 0.58. See, this is the value you got. And F1 score means, so you can substitute these values, you will get the same thing, 0.5285. So now you can check the classification report. So if you see the classification report, see here macro 0.5, here macro 0.5, precision score of the macro 0.5, here also be 0.5. So this is the macro of the 0.5 and recall of the 0.58. So here 0.58 and F1 score of the macro 0.53. See here 0.528 means it is approximately 0.53. So this macro is applicable to the number of instances 10, means all instances. So now we have to calculate the weighted average. So we will see how this value will get 0.47, 0.5 and 0.47. So this is the average based matrix. So this is the average weighted average based precision. If you see the precision score, actual, predicted and average weighted. So average weighted, if you see, point 466 means, which is the 0.47. If you see executed weighted, so here average is equal to weighted for the precision score, and it is the average weighted, it is equal to the of the recall score. So recall also be 0.5, here also be 0.5. And if you execute this value here, 0.4742 means it is the 0.47. So in classification report we got these three values: 0.47, 0.50, 0.47, like this. So by mathematically we will see how we will get this. So mathematically we have to calculate the weighted average matrix. So weighted average matrix means precision, recall and F1 score. Okay, so first we will see the weighted average precision. So what is the general precision formula? So general precision means TP by TP plus FP. So here I am writing the formula sigma I is equal to 1 to n mod yi divided by TPi by TPi plus FPi by sigma I is equal to 1 to n mod yi. So this is the formula for the precision with respect to the weighted. So the same formula can be written as equal to, so I equal to 1 to n, so n is equal to number of classes 3. So here this formula I can write like this: mod y1 tp1 by tp1 plus fp1, similarly mod y2 tp2 tp2 plus fp2 plus mod y3 into tp3 by tp3 plus fp3 divided by, so here I could 1 to n, n means y1 plus mod y2 plus mod y3. So the same formula can be write like this, the same formula. So here we will see what is the mod y1. So mod y1 means number of classes in actual values. So mod y2 means number of b's in actual value. Mod y3 means number of instances of class A in actual value. So actually number of instances of class A total 4 and 2. So you know, here in our confusion matrix, so here class A, class B, class C, this is the actual values. So under actual values we are taking it 2 to 0, 2 to 0, 2 to 1, 1, 2 to 1, 1, 0, 0, 2. So it means here total number of A 4, total number of B instances 4, total number of C instances 2. So this 4 is nothing but this. So this 4 is nothing but this 4, this 4 is nothing but this 4, and this 2 is nothing but this 2. So here this formula can be write like this. So mod y1 by, so here I wrote like this formula, means mod y1 plus mod y2 plus mod y3, can write mod y. So mod y1 means value 4 plus 4 plus 2 is equal to 10. So mod y is nothing but the 10 value. So here mod y into, so this is the formula precision of class A, precision of class A. So similarly mod y2 by y into precision of B, mod y3 by mod y into precision of class A. So y1 means 4, mod y means 10, so 4 by 10 into precision of A. So what is the meaning of precision of A? We already calculated in previous year confusion matrix. So this is the precision of A, 0.5, and precision of B 0.33, and precision of C 0.67. so these values we have to calculate here. So here precision of A 0.5, and here y2 means 4 by 10, precision of B nothing but the 0.33. So here 2 by 10, precision of C means 0.67. So if you calculate this value, you got the finally 0.47. So this is the 0.47. So this is the average based precision is equal to 0.466, which means this value is approximately 0.4, sorry, this value 0.47. So now we have to calculate the average based recall. So this is also be the same procedure. So here weighted average recall. So what is the formula? The same procedure. So sigma I is equal to 1 to n mod yi tpi by tpi plus fn. So recall means, what is the formula of recall? General formula, tp by tp plus fn. So fn, so that's why we are taking fni mod by mod I is equal to 1 to n mod yi. So this formula you can write like this: mod y1 by y into recall one, recall a, mod y2 by, I am writing the direct formula, I am not repeating same steps here. So mod y into recall of b, mod y3 by mod y into recall of c. So y1 means 4 by 10 into recall 1. So what is the recall of a? 0.5. 4 by 10 into recall of b, 0.25. 2 by 10 into recall of c, 1. So finally we got the answer 0.50. 0.50. If you see this value, 0.50. This is 0.50. And next, f1 score. So if you also calculate the weighted average f1 score. So weighted average f1 score means same here, mod by y into f1 score of class A plus mod y f1 score of the class B mod y by mod y3, sorry, y3 by y f1 score of the class C. So 4 by 10. So 4 by 10 means 0.4 into f1 score of a, f1 score of plus 5, 0.5, 0.4 into f1 score of plus b, 0.29, and 0.2 into plus c, 0.80. You will get the answer 0.476, which means its value 0.47. So 0.47. See, you got the 0.474, means this value 0.47. So we got this the value, this value, this value by mathematically, and also we by formula, precision score of the average is equal to the weighted, average is equal to weighted with respect to the recall score, and average is equal to weighted with respect to the f1 score. So that is the classification report. So if you see non weighted average basis, so what is the meaning of non weighted means? If you see this classification report once again, what is the values you got individually for class A? For class A, 0.50. For class B, 0.33, for class C, 0.67. So these three values we get at a time in this step, if you are mentioning the average is equal to none. So if you execute this statement, if you execute this cell, see, you got the same values, 0.5, 0.5, 0.333, 0.33, and 0.667 is equal to 0.67. So what is the values you got here in the classification report? So precision of every class, so here precision what you got, the same thing also we got, so 0.5, 0.33, 0.67. So here also be same. Similarly, recall of class B, recall of class A, class B, class C, these three values you got at a time in n, average is equal to none. So similarly, 0.5, 0.28 and 0.8, see 0.5, 0.29, 0.8. So this value you got at a time when average is equal to none. So from this confusion matrix, we calculated the each, this is the class C, we calculate the mathematically this value, this value, this value, and class B, every value mathematically we calculated, and at the same time every value we got the by through libraries, Prestone score and Prestone score of the none. If you see in the classification report, every value accuracy, so micro average based accuracy 0.5 and micro value, macro values and weighted average based matrix and unweighted average based matrix. So this is the concept behind the confusion matrix for the multi-class classification, macro average based matrix, micro average based matrix and the weighted average based matrix. So I think you like this video. If you have any kind of queries, please make it in comment section, and if you like this video, please share it and subscribe my YouTube channel. Thank you.